One, two, three, four, little dee, Within the year of 88, in the lovely month of June, the gadflies were dying of thirst and dogs were howling at the moon. With rosemary beads and sandwiches, our journey it began, and Jockster packed his German phrase book and jump leads for the van. Some of the lads had never been away from home before. 'Twas the first time Gems had ever ventured outside of Inchicore. But we had great faith in Jockster, for he'd often been away. He went as far as Sligo once to see Shamrock Rovers play.
Sligo?
As soon as we got in the ferry, Jockster met a man.
Oh God, here we go
then. Knew a dub that ran a pub not far from the Reaper Ban.
Oh.
At German immigration, our passports checked and seen, and we noticed the policemen were all dressed up in green. Take a look there at them squad cars. They're painted green and white.
Shower of hoods.
And tell you, boys, is Jockster, this place is going to be all right. Well, the Germans couldn't make head nor tail of
Wankers.
The English fans.
Cunts.
Jockster said that they reminded him of the Black and Tans.
Oh.
With swastikas and Union Jacks, and they're going mad to fight.
Folks,
an old German who'd lived through two world wars said he'd never seen the likes.
That's going shite.
Down the Autobahn, it was like the Long Mile Road. Buses, vans and bikes and cars all carrying the full load. I saw a Ford Transit from Cork City, an old Comer from Tralee, and engines overheating from long haul and duty free. There was fans from Ballyfermot, Ballybochan, Ballymun.
Up the dubs.
On the journey of a lifetime, and the crack was 91, Jockster met a German's daughter on the banks of the River Rhine. And he promised her she'd be welcome in Dublin anytime. As soon as we found Stuttgart, drove the wagons in a ring. Sean O got out the banjo and Peter played the mandolin.
On, Peter.
Fans from every part of Europe attracted by the sound. And Jockster fried their ashers and he passed the flagon round. When the session ended, Jockster tucked us in.
Intubator.
Tomorrow is the big one, lads. Got to win.
Up Ireland.
Then he blew up his old air mattress and he fell into a dream. He dreamt that Jack sent for him for advice to pick the team.
Hey up, kid.
Well, they both agreed in Bonner and on Houghton straight away. Morden, Whelan and McGrath were certainly to play.
Fair bet.
But tempers they began to rise and patience wearing thin. Jack wanted Cascarina, but Jockster wanted Quinn.
Quinn!
His dream turned to a nightmare. Jockster was on his knees to Jack, when he threatened to bring Johnny Giles and Eamon Dunphy back.
Oh, for Jesus.
And the cock
sake,
crew in the morning, and rowboat loud and shrill, and Jockster woke up in his sleeping bag many miles from Arbor Hill. Jockster blew the bugle. Get up, lads, rise and shine. Today we're playing England, and it's nearly opening time. As we gathered in the stadium and joined the sea of green, who'd scrimped and scraped and saved for months to support their team. What happened next is history, brought tears to many eyes. That day will be the highlight of many people's lives. My mother never saw a soccer match and she's nearly 69, but she had to send out for a nagging and the referee blew full time.
Make it a half bottle.
Jockster's home, safe and sound, and living with his mam.
Hi, mam.
Jackie Charlton's been proclaimed an honorary Irishman.
Fucking hell.
Well, the gadflies are all bursting, and the dog is doing fine, and the last time I saw Jockster, he was saying, who's this Conor Cruise O'Brien? See you at the World Cup, okay?